As well as orbiting the Sun, the Earth spins on its own axis, presenting a continuously changing face to the Sun, hence day and night. The Earth's axis is inclined, or tilted, at an angle of 66.5 degrees to the orbital plane. The inclination is sometimes stated as 23.5 degrees to the normal to the Earth's orbital plane. That is, 90 degrees minus 66.5 degrees equals 23.5 degrees. The inclination of the Earth's axis is the cause of the seasons and of the changing time interval between sunrise and sunset throughout the year. We specify the position of a point on the surface of the Earth using the latitude and longitude system. An imaginary graticule of lines covers the Earth's surface. The north-south lines join the north and south poles and are called meridians of longitude. The meridian passing through Greenwich is known as the prime meridian. The prime meridian is the datum for defining longitude. The east-west lines are parallel with the equator and are known as parallels of latitude. The equator is the datum from which latitude north or south is measured. A circle on the surface of the Earth, whose centre and radius are those of the Earth itself, is called a great circle. It's called great because a disc cut through the Earth in the plane of the great circle would have the largest area that can be achieved. A circle on the surface of the Earth whose centre and radius are not those of the Earth is called a small circle. The main small circles of relevance to position are the parallels of latitude. A rhomb line is a regularly curved line on the surface of the Earth which cuts all meridians at the same angle. That is, a line of constant direction. The Earth is divided into hemispheres, the most well-known ones being the northern and southern hemispheres, which lie north and south of the equator. Less well-known are the eastern and western hemispheres, which lie east and west of the prime meridian.